I'm going to play along with Say You Won't Let Go by James Arthur, and then we'll talk about the parts. Okay, a lot going on there. The intro is really cool. For the left hand, it's pretty much part of a G. If you look and listen carefully, I'm only strumming my sixth, third, and second strings. So if you look and listen at the left hand here, it doesn't really matter if I have my first finger and pinky on because I'm not strumming those strings. So I could go like this. I could hold the whole G chord and go. Oops. It's actually hard to do. I would just do those two fingers that you need. The middle finger on the sixth string third and the second string third. Capo three, by the way. In the right hand, I'm pretty much just using my thumb and my middle and ring finger. You could use your index and middle. I'm using my ring finger and middle finger. So here's what happens in the intro. You're going to do the sixth string by itself, and then the second and third string, and it's an abrupt rest, an abrupt stop. And then you release your ring finger and hit that chord, and then it finishes with a same thing happens with the D over F sharp. Now, because I'm doing D, I'm just doing my fourth string, third string, and second string. I guess I wouldn't have an X in there. You could. A lot of times a rest will be used as a rhythmic thing. I like the rest here better. Oops. Then we go back to E minor 7. And again, E minor 7 is usually something like this. But because of what we're strumming, only requires that one finger. And then traditional C. That last pull-off's kind of cool, so it goes C. Now on the recording, and as I played it, he does keep that intro going throughout that whole first verse and maybe what you'd call a pre-chorus. I met you in the dark and you lit me up. You made me feel it, whatever. I personally, if I was going to sing, I very likely would do the intro. And then after the intro, go right into chords. Now the strum that seemed natural for me was going to be something like this. Try and keep that going just on a G chord. 3, 4. You don't have to do exactly what I'm doing, but that gives you kind of the feel. Let me do the progression. 3, 4. That helps.